Hey everyone, how's it going? This is Ash, and a warm welcome to my very first model train review to come of January 2023. This one is the second TGV train pack I got for Christmas 2022. And yes, it is another Kato complete train pack in a two-part book set. And that's what I love about these train packs. They're compact, easy to store, B and N scale. You can use full scale length prototypical train formations on your model railway without it consuming too much space. Anyways, details are as follows. I'm just going to move my fingers out of the way so you can see the box, everybody. The reference number is 101. Let's start that again. 10-1762. TGV Lyria Euroduplex. And there is the Japanese translation, well, the original language at the bottom there too. So for those of you that can read and write Japanese, those details are for you to view at your own pleasure. And please feel free to pause the video if you want to make any notes of these details. But anyways, moving on. We do have part A and part B. And as you know, just to keep this nice and clean, I just put this on the bubble wrap, as you know. I like to keep my stuff nice and presentable and look after it, as it will serve me better. Opening up part one, and I'm just going to move the case out of the way just so I can show you part one better. We do have the booklet, and we will cover this first. So, without further ado, also, I have changed the battery over in my microphone as well, because the old one was beginning to wear off, so hopefully the sound quality on this video will be better than the last one. So at least that's now done and dusted. These are the details in both English and Japanese, although most of it is in Japanese, but it's quite easy to understand with the pictograms and stuff, okay? So that's part one of the manual. Very much identical to the last TGV train pack that I've covered. So, optional parts, and you can fit lighting kits into these models as well. And there is the light diffusers pre-installed, ready to go. So you can fit lights and all that good stuff. And DCC operations, as well as the ability to turn off the tail lights and stuff. That's all in this paragraph as well, folks. So, by all means, if we're going too fast, just hit pause and you can study this yourself. So, that's very much the instructions done. And these instructions is to install the optional lighting kit as well. So, very informative. Just take the body shell off, fit the LED module, and away you go, as the diffuser is already installed for ease of installation. And that's what I do love about Kato trains. They're very easy to use, very new to the hobby, user friendly. So no fuss, just fun. And that's the way I like it, folks. So just bear with me 2 wee seconds whilst I put the booklet back in the bag, okay? So just getting that done and dusted. So, okay, got this strip of bubble wrap just to keep the models firmly in place whilst in transit. And another thing you'll notice about this one, this is a brand new release that was released in 2022, and I like the fact that Kato have now implemented some openings in their packaging so we can grab the models much easier. And let's take a look at the locomotive then, folks. As you know, at the bottom it's all-wheel drive, although the only detractions is, whether you like them or dislike them, is that there is one traction tire here and there is another traction tire there. But just look at that colourful livery there, folks. Looks absolutely beautiful. And this train is the TGV Lyria that runs from France to Switzerland. So very nice, colourful, vibrant red, white and grey livery. Very, very nice in my opinion. So that's the locomotive done. And what I'm going to do, as I don't do the rotation on all of the carriages, as to be honest, it is impractical. And because the floor in this room is not level, what I'm going to do, I will take out the pieces of the train just to show you. And as you can see there, TGV Lyria branding. As well, and on other versions that just have TGV only. And this is based on the Camillan livery, as it's known. This is the first class compartment. There's the ends as well, just to show you everything, as I like to be thorough. And we do have the newer style Scharfenberg couplers, as it would be impractical to implement chain couplers like on the real things, but practicality has to come first, folks. So that's the first carriage done, and here is the other one. That just couples like the other train packs that I've recently done on the last two. And very nice, smooth, crisp livery application. No fuzz, no distortion, high quality all round. And these train packs, compared to the HO scale ones, are very good value for money. And what I will do this time around, once I've covered all the carriages, this is the other one. So you do get three first class, including one semi-articulated one. There's the bar car, which will come up next. And this obviously is another first class trailer. Very nice, crisp livery application. And just to show you the roof as well, as I want to be thorough, and I love to be thorough and candid and honest in my reviews. And here is the bar car, folks. So very stylish livery application. I do like that red, nice red flare on there as well. Really funky, if you ask me. And we've got the TGV Lyria branding as well. Let me just flip that around just to show you the other side too, and the couplers and everything. So very nice, crisp livery application, no distortions. And you can just make out the TGV Lyria. Apologies if I've not pronounced my French correctly there, because I don't speak French too often, as the last time I used my French language ability was when I was 16 years old back in my school days, but that was 26 years ago now, folks, so quite a long time ago. But very nice. And that, my friends, is part one done. But before we move on, I just want to cover this accessory pack, as I did miss this off in the last review, and I'm just trying to get my fingers in there, as it is quite a tight fit. But this is your blanking plug if you want to turn off the head or tail lights on the locomotive, if you should you decide to run this in multipole with another TGV, which you can do. And Kato do give you optional couplers, as you can remove the front end. Just bear with me, just going to put this back, just showing you the accessories. But I'm just going to show you the locomotive. This nose cone round here, folks, this does unclip, and you can use the coupler in its place and run this in multipole if you want to. So Kato has put a lot of thought and a lot of planning into these train packs. And what I'm going to do, I'm just going to close this one off, and I'm going to show you the second part. So just bear with me. Okay, we're on to part two. This is the second part of the two-piece bookcase set. And nice and convenient that the bubble wrap decided to stick to the case. That's grand. That makes it a whole lot quicker and easier. So without further ado, let's cover part two of the train pack then. This is your standard class trailers. Very nice, stylish livery, in my opinion. I really do like this black, silver and red livery. It really does look stylish, in my opinion. And the official name is known as the Camillan livery. And just showing you the other side as well, folks. Now imagine having one of these running on your model railway with the optional light bars fitted. That would really look cool, don't you think? And here is another standard class, so I've just shown you the same. Only difference, just the name on the side, folks. So very easy to assemble the consists, as Kato has packed it in the correct formation. So you just got to join them together and away you go. So that's that one done. Just do this one very quickly, as I like to keep these videos interesting and that, and not keep you too long on the introduction, okay? So that's the trailer done, and we've got the semi-articulated one here as well. So very nice train pack from Kato, and I'm glad I got this one for Christmas, so I'm very, very happy. And very nice detail all round. Okay, now we're on to the other locomotive, of course, not part, and you can raise and lower the pantographs, but I'm not going to keep repeating this on every single video, so I'll just keep them down just for this review, okay? And nice crisp livery application complete, if you can see that on the camera. We've got the SNCF and the SBB rail operator brands just on the base of the locomotive there, folks. Not sure if the camera is picking that up clearly or not, but I just wanted to show you that. Very nice all round, and just to let you know is that the models do have full working directional head and tail lights, and there's a basic cab interior in there as well, so I'm just trying to show you that on camera too, as to be honest, when I do the rotation, which is coming up next along with a close-up, and I will do that of the motor car, I can't really show you too much of the roof detail, as the camera is just not high enough from when I do the rotation and stuff. And we've got a broken piece in here, so unfortunately I'm gonna have to take a point off the quality for that. So there's a tab that's broken off in there, I don't know where it's from, but I will get to the bottom of it. But that's how it came to me, folks. But that's all for now, that's the introduction done. So the next thing for me to do is the rotation, well, the close-ups, rotation, and of course we'll have some fun with the performance test. Okay, folks, it's now time for us to do the close-ups. So without further ado, let's take the camera, and just for the benefit of the close-ups, I've just shown the AC pantograph in the raised position, and we do have the France Swiss branding on the sides, as we showed briefly in the close-ups, well, in the introduction. TGV Lyria, and here is the fleet number, so just zooming onto that. This one is numbered as 4720 and is one of the TGV Euroduplexes. Overall, it is a very nice train, and you may have noticed that this one is a bit different to the SNCF TGV version, as there is no SNCF branding on the front, although it is on the sides, along with SBB, as these are joint owned by the two companies, I believe, and these run from Paris to Zurich, if my memory serves me correctly. So, just zooming out to regain focus on the camera, and I'll just show you along the side of the train as well. But as you can see there, folks, very nice crisp livery application from Kato, and Kato has done a good job on these models. So all in all, I would definitely recommend them. And that's the close-ups done. As you know, it's just the locomotives I do the close-up of in these reviews of these train packs, as it makes the job easier, well, for me anyways. And that, my friends, is the close-ups done. So the next thing for me to do is to move on to the rotation. Then we will have some fun with the performance test. It's now time to do the rotation before we move on to having some fun with the performance test. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to zoom out enough to show you the locomotive without it cropping. and it is quite a long one, so I'm just going to zoom out a wee bit more just to show you the details and stuff. So just altering the camera as we go, so I like to be thorough and make sure the train is completely covered, you know. But I'm letting the detail do very much self-explanatory, and it is a nice model from Kato in my opinion, and I think Kato has done a grand job, although I would like them to do, or at least consider doing, a re-release of the TGV Rousseau train packs, as I would like one of those in the Camillan livery as well, as I do use that train a lot on Train Simulator Classic, so that would be a nice addition to add to my collection. But anyway, sticking on topic with this type of TGV, that, my friends, is the end of the rotation. So it's now time to have some fun with a performance test, and we do have a new background train. That's all I'm going to say, folks, but I will lower the AC pantograph on the front motor unit, as it is prototypical, due to the fact that the train has a high voltage cable from the front locomotive to the back, so the front pantographs are not normally used when these trains are running along the LGV tracks across France. So I will replicate that in the performance test. Okay, folks, it's now time for us to have some fun with the performance test. And what I'm going to do, as I like to start off with a zoomed in on the power car. So we're just going to zoom out, and I will show you my temporary layout of Tren El Paradiso. And without further ado, what we'll do first, we'll start up the background train, which is a freight train and a Class 60. So let's get that one started first then, folks. And without further ado, let's power up the TGV Lyria, and let's see how well the performance test will go. And I'm taking this up to about exactly 50% power. As you know, this is exactly 50% power. And as you can see, the model is quite fast off the mark. So it's got lots of acceleration, very responsive, of which I'd assume, just like its real life counterpart. Acceleration is good all round. The locomotive does have all-wheel drive, a five-pole cam motor, and flywheels as well to give it smooth acceleration and deacceleration, so that eliminates the choppiness that you get from the drive lines without flywheel drive. And I do hope that my sound is better this time around. So I have changed the battery over in the microphone, and all in all, I really am enjoying this new start. In fact, I'm just going to reposition the microphone, and I will be right back, so just bear with me. Okay, I hope you can hear me better now, as the microphone was behind me, so I do apologise for that, but I hope you could hear me no matter, irrespective anyways. But as you can see there, that's exactly 50% power, and I've not got it any higher than that, so I'm going to knock that down to about 40% power, because it was going a wee bit too fast just for this small size model railway. As you know, this is Tren El Paradiso phase one, and it's just a temporary layout until I've moved to somewhere more permanent, because when I do start work on phase two, and that may become phase three, I do plan to have lots of track, many lanes with multiple trains running. That is the plan, folks, and it all will be Kato Unitrack. So I'm a big fan on Kato, because I find Kato track is very easy to use. So all in all, performance is very, very good. As you can see, the ambience of the headlights is about right. Not too bright, not too dull. As to be honest, with some brands of model trains, their headlights can be a bit too bright, but these Kato ones, they do light up reasonably well without being too strong. And not to forget as well, if you add the light bars, well, the lighting modules into the coaches, this would really make a nice train running at night. However, if you are a DCC user, you would need to add a decoder into every carriage to control the lighting, or add some resistors just so that the 18 volts AC doesn't destroy the LEDs, as I think they are rated for 12 volts DC maximum. I don't know, as I've not yet fitted any of them, but I'm assuming they are 12 volts DC. So you would have to add resistors just to protect the LEDs. But that said, folks, the train does look very nice without them, and it is a very nice smooth runner. And this is the second TGV that I got for Christmas, as the other duplex that I got was a Resso duplex that I covered up as the very last review of 2022. So I thought I'd start my 2023 reviews with another TGV that I got for Christmas, and I really am happy, folks. Okay, what I'm going to do, I will allow two more passes after this one, and then I will switch the camera just to show you the tail lights on the unpowered motor car on the back. Okay, so one more after this and we will switch the camera. So all in all, I really am enjoying this review to kickstart January. And okay, so once these trains have cleared the filming zone, I will cut the camera. Okay, folks, this should show you the tail lights on the back of the train, and I want you to make judgments for yourselves on how you determined the brightness, the accuracy and the quality. As from my point of view, as I like to be honest, candid and unbiased, but from my buyer's point of view, as I like to give this from a truthful buyer's point of view, from when someone goes to buy one of these train packs for themselves, of what their views are on these train packs, as I like to review them honestly. Personally, just like with the last two that I've done from Kato, the brightness seems to be about right. And I'm just going by the ones I've seen on Trains in World 3. The brightness seems to be about the same as those. So they don't seem to be too bright, and they don't seem to be too dull either, which is grand, and that is a good thing. Also, you can see my other Class 60 running in the background with the tanker train, and that will be reviewed this month in January. And there's a reason I'm saving this one till last, is because when it goes live on the channel, it will be done as the very last model train review to come of the Lunar New Year of the Tiger, which ran from 2022 to January the 21st, 2023. So that one will tee off the Year of the Train, as I call it. So that one will come up not next week, but the week after. That's when you'll see that plastic being reviewed, folks. As this TGV, I wanted to kickstart 2023 with a super awesome high-speed passenger train. And I'm a big fan of the French TGVs, even though this one is for Europe in general, as these TGVs also do run from France to Spain, as well as Switzerland, Germany, and I do believe into Belgium and the Netherlands as well. So they do cover quite a bit of Europe, to be honest with you folks. These TGVs do. But I like the shape of these power cars as well, as these are the Mark 4 or possibly even the Mark 5 compared to the two Mark 3 TGVs that I covered in the previous two packs that I owned from Kato. So what do you think of these train packs then, folks? If you're interested in TGVs, I would definitely would recommend going out there and getting one. However, there was a loose part in the box from mine, from this train pack, so I will have to take off the point on quality. Of which I do roll in as features and quality. Well, features and details, but quality, I'm taking a point off, as there is performance and price as well. So, okay, what I will do, I will allow one more pass, and then it will soon be time to start wrapping up this review then, folks, okay? Right, folks, now it's time to start winding down and wrapping up this review. I do hope you enjoyed this one. As you know, I like to be thorough, clear and concise on my reviews. Personally, I do find these Kato TGV train packs superb value for money. They really are very nice train packs in my opinion. So, let's break it down then. Detail and features. I'm going to give that a 5 out of 5. You've got directional lighting. You've got the option to add interior lighting for the coaches, of which Kato do supply lighting kits for those, as they do them in packs of individuals and fixed pack as well. And the reference numbers for those lighting packs are in the instructions, which I covered at the start of this review. Quality. I'm going to take off 1 point due to the fact that I did find a loose part inside the box. Price. I find them very fantastic value for money, and for what you do get from Kato, they are amazing value. They run well, they are made well, the livery application is crisp, and you do get a lot of detail for your money. And these are a lot cheaper than most HO scale brands, and you get the complete train all set to go. You don't have to buy extra carriage packs and stuff, you know. So, price is excellent. I'm giving that a 5 out of 5. Performance, very smooth. 5-pole motor with all-wheel drive and a flywheel drive mechanism makes it very silky smooth. And I would put Kato on par with Rolls-Royce and Bentley. If they were to make model trains, this would be it in terms of the quality and the, well, in terms of the performance. So, under normal circumstances, I've never had a bad experience with a Kato model. I just don't know why that loose part was in the box. Maybe it's a buffer or something that might have come off, but if so, I'll just put it back on. But the only reason I've taken a point off the quality, because normally Kato, in terms of their performance and the quality of the model trains, it's some of the best I've seen. But that's only a minor detraction, but I am firm but fair with my scores, and that's why I've taken a point off quality. The features and detail, 5 out of 5. Quality, 4 out of 5. Performance, 5 out of 5, as evident in the video. Price, 5 out of 5. So, that rounds our final score for this color. TGV Lyria Euroduplex with a 9 out of 10. As if it wasn't for that loose part in the box, this would have earned a perfect 10. But as you know, I'm not going to turn a blind eye to things like parts coming off the models, you know. So a 9 out of 10 is a fair and a justified score. Anyway, folks, I just want to say to you, if you stayed with me through to the end of this video and watched all the way from the start to finish, I just want to say to you a big thank you for watching. As always, take care of yourselves and each other. All the best. God bless. Look after yourselves, look after each other, and I will see you in the next model train review to come very soon. If you're here for the model train reviews, they are every Saturday at 11 a.m. And the next uploads in terms of Let's Plays will be up soon as well. But that's all for now, folks. I just want to say to you, I will see you in the next one. And keep smiling, stay solid, stay positive, and don't let the winter blues bite.